And welcome back to American Agenda. Former President Obama holding his star-studded birthday bash over the weekend, as one attendee reportedly described it as the party of all parties. All of this coming as he promised President Obama, former president, that it would be limited to close family and friends due to COVID fears. But the photos show pretty much otherwise, with about 200 guests in attendance. Here is how a New York Times reporter defended the situation.
And all the safety precautions. People are going to sporting events that are bigger than this. This is going to be safe. This is a sophisticated, vaccinated crowd. And this is just about optics. It's not about safety.
Let's bring back in our panel for their reactions to this. And Ford, I'll start with you. More example of hypocrisy.
Look, I got to thank the New York Times reporter. She said it straight for me. Apparently, it's the sophisticated who don't get COVID, and the rest of us are rubes who must comply with inconsistent rules, and we can never hold weddings or parties over five people until there's zero COVID. I got it now. It's all clear.
Yeah, you know, I mean, Melanie, to say that, you know, these were sophisticated folks who were vaccinated, so therefore it was okay. Well, you know, at least one person out on social media said that she knew of at least two people there personally who were not vaccinated. So being vaccinated was not something that you had to do in order to go to the party.
The thing that irks me the most about people on the left is that they so claim that they're like down for the common people, yeah. And they're such elitists. Like, it just burns me up. And comments like that are like exhibit A. They're sophisticated, vaccinated people. Really?
Yeah.
So, you know, like all the rest of us scrubs who are unvaccinated and just not sophisticated wouldn't know how to hang with an Obama crowd.
Yeah.
So therefore, that's why they get to party with, you know, 200 of their closest friends. They're such hypocrites. And this is why, and because they wouldn't, you know, nobody on the left, including, you know, Circle Back Jen Psaki, would like bash this party, mm-hmm. You know, is why the American people are giving the CDC and the Biden administration the side eye every time we get some type of advice or guidance, because they allow stuff like that and they say nothing.
Right. And speaking of that, Dr. Fauci already out and commenting on how wrong it is to have the Sturgis motorcycle rally, which is going on in South Dakota, saying that that's a potential super spreader, Bob.
Yeah, exactly. Doesn't mention what's going on at the Obama mansion.
No.
And it also, what bothers me is not only the hypocrisy, But the president is trying to convince people that they should follow mask mandates and vaccine mandates. Leave that issue aside for a second and just say, you have his former president, the guy that he was with for 8 years, working day in and day out, ignoring the guidance.
Yeah. Matthew, what do you think about it? Because on the other hand, I was thinking, well, go ahead, go have your party. Don't wear masks. But let the rest of us do that, too.
There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it is. It is the height of hypocrisy. And it goes back to what I was saying a second ago in the Senator Rand Paul segment, that the left will push and probe to see what they can get away with the people, with us. So if we let them have this big party, but we continue to stay in our house and continue to not make decisions that are good for us, it just encourages them to keep pushing. So it is the height of hypocrisy. And, of course, Fauci didn't condemn it. He condemns a motorcycle rally. Can you imagine if President Trump or current Governor Ron DeSantis did something like this, what the media would be doing?
Oh, yeah, I can imagine it, because the media has done it. The media does speak out against, you know,
yeah,
conservatives or those that they deem to be, you know, not. What was the word that the New York Times reporter used, Melanie?
Not sophisticated.
Yes. Unsophisticated.
Yeah, all us unsophisticated people. Come on. All right. Well, Ford O'Connell, Melanie Collette, and Matthew Russell, thank you all for joining us.
All very sophisticated.
Thank you.
Very
appreciate
sophisticated. Coming up, more of American Agenda after this.